Did you know that 66% of men end up experiencing some form of hair loss by the age of 35? And that number only goes up as you continue to age. And that's more than half of us experiencing male pattern baldness. This is one of the most common balding problems that us men face. And you'll probably see at least every third or fourth guy walking down the street with male pattern baldness. And in this video, I wanna help you self-diagnose some of the things to find out if you are having male pattern baldness, otherwise known as androgenic alopecia, or you simply just had a stressful week. And depending on which one it is, I'll share some tips and tricks with you that you can use to slow down your hair loss and come up with some sort of regimen or plan that will help you keep your hair for as long as possible and not have to get a hair transplant like I did last year. And if that's the case, that's not a problem too. I can help you out with that. But anyways, with that being said, let's go ahead and jump right into the video. Hair loss can be caused by a variety of different things that may not be genetic or may not even be male pattern baldness or otherwise known as androgenic alopecia. Some of those things may include high stress levels, hormonal imbalances, improper sleep, dietary deficiencies, or just simply bad hair habits. So if you're lacking one of these or a few of these, this is something that you want to assess and evaluate to see where you can improve. Maybe it might just be switching out the shampoo or conditioner that you're using that just might be something you've been using since you're 5 years old and that stuff is just full of crap. If you're facing that and hormonal imbalances, dietary deficiency, all those things can be fixed. That's not going to give you permanent hair loss. The thing that we have to worry about is androgenic alopecia, otherwise known as male pattern baldness. That's the hair loss that your grandfather, your uncle, your dad, somebody in your family history had, and that one, once it starts, so that's when you have to start treatments and come up with some sort of hair regimen to hold on to your hair for as long as possible. Now, you might be asking, hey, how do I know if I am facing male pattern baldness? The easiest way for you to know if this is something that might be a problem for you in the future, if not now, is looking at your family history. See who is bald. Do you have a bald grandpa? Do you have a bald dad? A bald uncle? Like, is this something that is a common pattern that runs in your family? And if it is, then you definitely want to come up with a regimen and a plan to make sure that you delay this part of your life as long as you possibly can, unless you don't care about losing the hair, right? But if you didn't care about losing the hair, you wouldn't be watching the video right now. That's probably the best and number one spot that you want to start at, and that will give you a good indication on if you're going to be losing hair or not. So male pattern baldness starts for most people at the crown back over here and at the temples up over here. So basically the way that is determined is going to be on a Norwood scale. A Norwood scale goes from 1 to 6, is used to assess the severity of your hair loss. Most people will start off at maybe a Norwood 2, and then as the years progress, they'll go to a 3, 4, 5, and eventually, you know, a 6, if that's something that they are genetically conditioned for. An easy way for you to go ahead and find out if you're going to be losing hair is to, one, start with the crown back over here. I just recommend opening up the camera app on your phone and going on to the selfie mode, and then simply snapping a picture of your hair just like this. And just like that, basically, you know, you'd be able to see how severe your hair loss is if you're losing hair. So for me, my hair loss started like literally right here from the crown area when I was 19. And then slowly, you know, it kind of progressed. But I got a hair transplant and fixed all of this. But that's the first spot where I noticed my hair thinning. Now, the second spot that you want to look out for is your temples right over here. So this is another very common place that you're going to end up losing hair. Notice most of these things that will happen very gradually. So you may think you're 100% okay. And then little by little, you know, year after year, you might just see that, hey, 2 years ago, if you look at some older pictures, you'll realize maybe your hairline was a lot lower, and this year it all of a sudden it just got higher. But the truth is, it didn't just happen all of a sudden. It happened gradually, and since you see yourself every day, you don't really notice like these minor changes until you compare a photo of, you know, you 2 years ago versus you now, and that's when you're like, holy crap, I'm losing hair. So go ahead and assess your temples. I'll actually put up some b-roll of how my temples used to look before I got my hair transplant. They were actually really bad, and they went like really bad to the point where it made almost like a V, and that's basically the starting of my overall hair. So the way that's supposed to work is that slowly your temples go back, your crown ends up coming up close, and then slowly inches like this, and then comes to the point where you're just completely bald from the top, and you have your side hairs just remaining because those aren't like DHT sensitive. So that's one most common scenario on spotting your hair loss, your crown and your vertex. And that's gonna be the case for a majority of the people. Now, there's a second category of people that I've seen lose hair, and it doesn't start from vertex or it doesn't start from the crown. Where it starts for them is just thinning hair all around. And in everyday, day-to-day situations, their hair may seem normal. It doesn't seem like much is happening. But when their hair is wet or when there is some harsh sunlight going on right directly over their head, you can see right through their scalp. And that one is kind of a tricky one because you don't even know if you're actually losing hair because, you know, you're like, oh, my hair is just getting thin all of a sudden. It's just kind of miniaturizing. And for that, again, you want to do a test to see if that's going to be you. So the easiest way to do that is going to be in the shower. Once your hair is wet and you can just completely see right through and your hair is just extremely thin, then that's a cause for concern. And that means you have to start doing some treatments if you want to go ahead and reverse that. Now, regardless of the case, whether you are scenario A, where you're losing hair on the vertex and the crown, or scenario B, where you're thinning all around, another very, very easy and simple way to spot your hair loss is going to be at two places. One is where you sleep, and second is where you shower. If you think you're facing hair loss or you're going bald, go ahead and switch out your pillowcase to something that contrasts the color of your hair. So if you have black hair, just sleep on white sheets. If you have blonde or, you know, any other colored hair, you just want to get a sheet color that would just contrast it. And when you wake up, just look at your pillow. Like, how much hair do you have, or how much hair have you lost overnight? And it is absolutely normal for people to lose about 100 hairs per day. That hair is just kind of, you know, just going through its hair cycles and it just sheds and grows back. But if you see excessive hair loss on your pillow, and secondly, if you see excessive hair loss in your shower after you're done showering, just look at your bathtub, right? If you have a lot of hair just right there, then obviously that's another cause for concern, and that means that it's going to be, unfortunately, male pattern baldness. This is something that my friend was going through when I went over to his place, just kind of hanging out, and I just went to the bathroom and I just took a peep in his shower and I just saw so much hair on the floor, and I was like, yo, dude, like, I think you're going to be going bald soon. And he didn't believe me at the time, but 1 year later, he's like, bro, I need your help, you know, I need to help come up with a hair growth regimen. I think I'm losing out. Like, I told you last year, man, I saw your bathtub. That's an easy, very easy and effective way for you to spot your hair loss regardless of you losing it the first way, which is gonna be miniaturizing like this or just thinning all around. From all the things that we talked about, if one or all of these things you can resonate with and you are actually losing hair, what can we do out there? It's unfortunately, yeah, it is a bad situation, but luckily we do have options. We do have treatments available readily for you that you can use to go ahead and reverse your hair loss or at least slow it down so that way you're delaying your hair transplant process, as this is a pretty invasive and lengthy process that you wouldn't be the most comfortable doing, especially if you're just like a Norwood one. So the first protocol I would recommend anybody facing hair loss I would get on is definitely minoxidil. Minoxidil has been one of the cornerstones I've been using for the past 6 years now at this point, which is like insane to think about. But that's something that I've been using myself that's been helping me retain a lot of my hair. Had it not been for minoxidil, I think I would have probably been bald a lot faster than, you know, right now. Now, even after my hair transplant, I still use minoxidil because the cost versus the benefits is absolutely insane. It does take a little bit to work, so you want to be consistent with it for at least 6 months before you can expect any crazy results. Now, the second thing that I paired with, which I wish I had known a lot sooner, which would definitely would put minoxidil on steroids, because statistically it's been proven to increase the results of minoxidil by up to 150%, is going to be using a derma roller. I personally have this derma pen thing, so basically it has like some needles over here. It just creates like a mini wound in the area that you're losing hair, and it's nothing that's like, you know, too painful or crazy like that. But the point of this is that and this is a very common dermatology practice that they use on your skin, but when you do it up on your hair, it actually produces collagen in the area. Again, same thing, awakening those hair follicles that have miniaturized and unfortunately died. This goes ahead and wakes those bad boys up, and combining these two would be a absolute game changer in terms of helping you get your hair back. This is something that you'd probably be applying every single day. You use this once a week, and the day that you use a derma roller, you wouldn't use the minoxidil. These two would be my go-to protocol in terms of helping you slow down your hair loss and get most of your hair back. Now, if you want to go ahead and take it a step further and stop hair loss from its root, and the root of it is a hormone or a testosterone known as DHT. So excessive DHT produced in your body is what's causing the hair loss itself. And in order for you to combat that, this is the drug I take. It's a 1 milligram of finasteride. This is something that you definitely want to get prescribed by your doctor to ensure that you're not facing any crazy side effects. I've been taking it for the past 6 years, no problems, and, you know, I've been pretty good with it. So the side effects for this are very rare, but again, you definitely want to consult a doctor to make sure that you are the right person for this pill before you go ahead and end up ingesting it. Regardless of whatever you do, whether that's natural, whether that's drugs, whether that's oils, whether that's low-level laser therapy, whatever it is that you do, the key is consistency. If hair is something that's important to you and something that you value, these treatments that you're going to be doing is going to have to become a habit, like just like you're brushing your teeth. Just like before I go to sleep, I make sure I don't sleep before I apply minoxidil. Or just like every week, I make sure that I get my derma rolling session in, or derma pen session, I should say, and before you know, I end my Sundays. So just like that, unfortunately, yes, it does have to become a routine. It does have to become a habit, but costs and the benefits of actually using, having to use these products and having to retain my hair outweighs all the inconvenience of having to use them. So yes, it is a bit of an adjustment process, but the key is absolutely consistency, because without consistency, you might as well just not take anything and just let your hair go to waste. Now, let's say you're just too far gone down the process. You do know that you're bald and you're just past the point where you will see any significant results, like I was. Like I was past the point where I could even realistically get my hair or my hairline back or my crown back with, you know, just minoxidil and a finasteride, right? These two together were just doing the best they can to helping me hold on to my hair for as long as possible. But there came a point where, you know, the efficacy couldn't get any better. So that's when I decided to get a hair transplant. So if you're at that point, I know that process also seems overwhelming. You don't know where to start. You don't know how expensive it's going to be. And for that, I would highly recommend doing it overseas in Turkey. That's where I've personally got my hair transplant. And I can just tell you, it is one of the best decisions I've made, having to get basically the hair of my dreams back. You can definitely get a quality job for a fraction of the price that you would be paying in the US. And if you're curious on what it looks like, what to expect getting your hair transplant in Turkey, I've actually documented the entire process of getting my own hair transplant done in Turkey at Vera Clinic. I'll also leave a link to that in the description below so you can check that out, so you know exactly what to expect. In case you're losing hair, I hope this video helped you and guided you in terms of identifying your hair loss, and also gave you some ideas on what to do if you are, that will help you slow down your hair loss and help you hold on to your hair for as long as possible, because I know it can feel soul crushing. It can take a huge toll on your confidence. And I just hope this video helped you bridge that gap in between and helping you get your hair back. So if you guys did enjoy this video, please make sure to let me know by giving it a thumbs up, and let me know in the comment section below, when did you find out that you're losing hair? I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.